Hello, Thamesmead, and welcome to TEMO TV, a brand new mini-series from our lounge to your lounge. I'm Adriana, I work for Peabody in Thamesmead, managing all of our cultural activities, and we've been working with some fantastic local talent and local residents this week to bring you the best jokes, cooking demonstrations, some laughing yoga, which you just have to try, dance moves, and also some craft ideas just in time to celebrate VE Day tomorrow, all in the hope that it makes lockdown a little bit more bearable and a little bit more fun. We're going to be coming to you every week on a Friday at 4 p.m. and every week is going to be focused around a new theme, kicking off today with love and community.
My name is Kwame Augustine. I'm a writer, actor, poet, and this is a piece I wrote called Wish You Were Here. Dear all, to whom it may concern, I'm excited to put pen to paper, to tell you about a town I truly favour. A town not known by many, but revered by many. The brutalist architecture that can be seen by so many. From the magazines, movies, music videos, fictional series on the telly. Visions from locals of a new wave. Full HD with no static. The town is moving forward, we can feel it in the air. The optimistic nature of the people is spreading through the town like wildfire. And no amount of water from the River Thames could put it out. Oh, how I wish you were here. I wish you could come and see what I see. I wish you could come to Thamesmead. Thamesmead Town. The town of wildlife, the town of greenery. The town of me, the town of many. The town of mothers, fathers, daughters and sons. The town of artists, doctors, lovers and culture. The town of diversity. Trust me, this town is certy. Oh yes indeed, this town is certified. The rivers, the lakes, the buildings can all be personified by the rich mix of the local people. So unlike a sentimental scene, I will not bid you adieu, but more like, what's going on, people? When you're coming through to Thamesmead.
Hello, guys. My name is Carl.
And my name is Sherelle. And together, we are
Infinity Catering. Today, we're going to cook Jamaica's national dish.
Ackee and saltfish with fried dumplings.
We're going to be using a whole onion, spring onions, scotch bonnet pepper, fresh garlic, fresh thyme, mixed peppers, some minced garlic here, coarse black pepper, fresh ackee. Our cod saltfish.
As you can see, we have a pot full of boiling water. Now what I'm going to do is add the saltfish to it, because saltfish is quite salty, so I'm adding it to it just to dilute some of the salt. Do this process about 2 to 3 times for about 10 to 15 minutes and taste it. If it's to your taste, then you know it's ready. We'll start the process by chopping up these white onions. Chop up these spring onions or scallion. Now I'm going to start with the scotch bonnet. Some fresh garlic. The reason why I like using red peppers and the green peppers and the yellow peppers is because it reminds me of being in Jamaica. Some of this thyme as well.
Put your pot on the fire and make sure that it is hot. And we're going to just add a little bit of olive oil, about 2 tablespoons. Add our tablespoon of minced garlic.
We've got adding our ingredients. You can do it in any order, but I prefer to start with the smaller bits first.
You want to get all those flavours engraved and induced into one another. Okay, so we're going to add some thyme into that. Probably just make that simmer for about 2 to 3 minutes. We don't want nothing to be burned, we want it to be caramelised.
Our onions, mixed peppers and garlic is now simmered. So now we're going to add in our saltfish. So the saltfish is now boiled. So now we're just going to crumble it in
and stir it up. We're just going to let this cook down for about 2 minutes.
This is our beautiful ackee, all washed up and cleaned up and drained up.
Be gentle with the ackee, because if you turn it over, it will crush and it will spoil. So just leave it as it is for about 3 to 5 minutes. Just let it simmer down before you start turning everything over. And also, you can't forget your black pepper. Okay guys, so as you can see, this is in the pot. Just let it simmer for about 3 to 5 minutes with the lid on. And stay tuned.
We've got here, we've got a cup of self-raising flour, a cup of water, Also, we've got about 2 tablespoons of butter, and we've got 2 teaspoons of baking powder, and we're also going to use a pinch or 2 of salt. So first of all, we're going to put in the self-raising flour. Okay, so now we've added in our butter, our baking powder, and our self-raising flour. So we're just going to mix up everything together so we can get that crumbly effect.
Just divide a little section inside of the flour. Then you pour water into the middle. You don't want to get it too wet, and you don't want to get it too soft. And you can also add flour in at any time. So what we're going to do now is just roll it up into a ball again, and we'll just leave it inside of the tin for about 10 minutes so it can rise.
We've sprinkled a bit of self-raising flour on the board, and now you can see it's got a nice doughy texture. What we've done is preheated the oil, and now we're just going to roll up our dumplings.
The dumplings are all ready. They look so juicy and fluffy.
Lovely. That's what you want to see in your dumpling. Fluffy. Nice and golden, crispy brown.
And now to serve up our ackee and saltfish. And a little sprinkle of parsley. Some fried plantain.
Hi everyone, it's Abana Pongasari. I'm your local MP for Erith and Thamesmead. Hope you're all staying safe and not going too crazy during this lockdown. So important that we protect ourselves and our loved ones. I'm looking forward to supporting TEMO TV and seeing how it develops. So watch this space.
I'm Ridden Tyson. I know that it's hard being away from your loved ones, but I suggest you use the chance to appreciate those who love you. For instance, I'm using the time to really get to know the person that I love the most. Myself.
And that was the Lockdown Variety Hour.
Hi there. I'm Tatiana, and this is
Tori,
and we are from Firefly Fitness UK. And what are we going to do today?
We're going to be doing a dance called 2C Slide, and we added our own little spin onto it.
So let's go, and we'll show you the steps first, and then what we're going to do is play the music, and hopefully you can join in. All right? So the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to be facing sideways, and one leg is going to be up like this. And one hand is going to be on your head like this, simulating a hat. Okay? So what you do next is you bring your hips up just like Michael Jackson. Yes, if you got that. So we're going to be going up and down for 2. Okay? So your head goes like that. 1 and 2. You bring the leg back. Toe comes down. And then the leg goes forward again. And then we're turning, arm comes out, and then you're going to drop your head down.
It's like a little knot.
Yeah, you drop down and up, okay? And that's how, that's the first part of the dance. So let's take it again. So we're going to go 1 and 2 and back and forwards and turn and down and up. Oh, nearly knocked you out then. Cool, blimey.
Next in our dance, we go from here to...
Yeah.
We go this.
Two.
Just because like we're getting a bit close, we want to have space again.
Yeah, and so you bop back, bop back. A nice little jump back. Then we move into the dance.
So it goes right foot up, then left
foot.
So you have to put your foot up and
slide. And then slide. And then left foot up, right foot slide. Yes.
So.
Right foot up, left foot slide,
left foot up, up. Right.
Yeah. Then we move on to the next part. You push your body to the side, push your body to the side. We've only got two of these. And one and two.
But if you're doing it with a partner like me and my mum, we have to like do it on the same side. So
we're going to start to that side first. So we go one and two and one and two. Yeah, it's only two, but you've got to practice it a few times to get it in your head. Then we're really excited. We're doing like a cross jump. Yeah. So you go one and two. Yeah.
But
simple.
You need to do it like once each way.
Yeah.
So you go one.
So you cross over one leg in front, the other leg in back, and then you're going to turn your body. And you're going to turn into the Michael Jackson.
Yes.
Like up with the feet. And up. Woo! Yeah. That is it in a nutshell. Yes! We've reached that point now.
Are you ready?
Are you sure you're ready?
Say that again.
Yeah, I can't hear you. Okay, here we go. We're going to go into the dance.
I could dance like Michael Jackson. I could give you satisfaction. And you know we out here every day with it. I'm going to show you how to get it. Go right foot.
Jane, and I'm going to be doing a craft project with you today, something that's really easy to have a go at home no matter what you've got lying around, and that is bunting. I made this bunting out of old magazines, but you can even use newspaper, or if you've got it, then use some white paper like that, perhaps something that you have in a printer. The best way to make your bunting is to have a template. Just a triangle, something like that, but have a flap on the top so that you can fold it over and stick it onto your string when you come to actually string your bunting together. But whatever you decide to do, cut out your template, your triangle, and then decorate it with whatever you've got handy. I've done one here using hearts made out of an old Easter egg wrapper. That really says love to me. If you've got newspaper and you don't have anything else, you can even make really pretty bunting using newspaper. And with this one, I put on the colours of the rainbow and cut out a little butterfly as well, just to make it look extra special. However you decide to do your bunting, when you've finished, and you want to maybe make six or seven of these at least, the size to go in your window so that all your friends can see it. When you've finished, take the back of your bunting with its little flap and get some glue and stick all the way along that flap. And then you can put it over a piece of string just like that. So it's going to stick onto the string and you can have all your flags hanging along the piece of string. Make sure though that you leave a nice long bit at the end and tie a loop so that you can hang it onto a drawing pin or something on your window and actually string your bunting up. Now, if you don't want to make bunting out of paper and you fancy doing something a little bit different, another suggestion is to make bunting like this. And believe it or not, it's not a necklace, although it could be, but it's actually bunting made out of strips of t-shirt, some wool that I had at home, and then a piece of old washing line, which was this nice colour red, and I just thought it would work really well. You just loop it over your piece of string, again, leaving a nice long bit at each end so that you can actually hang it up. Let me show you how to do the loops. Whatever way you decide to do your bunting, I hope you really have fun. And have a go, share the idea with your friends. And if you all have some in your houses, it's going to look really pretty and really help cheer us all up. Really? Oh. I'm Patricia and I'm here to talk to you about laughter and basically why it is the best medicine. Every time we laugh, we start to release feel-good hormones, which are called endorphins. And endorphins bring down the stress hormone, which is called cortisol. And when we laugh, it literally switches our brain from stress mode, which is called fight or flight,
into calm mode, which is called rest and digest. Through laughter, we create more T cells, and these are what help our body to fight disease. So laughing alone can actually boost your immunity.
It's called laughter yoga, but actually it's just laughing. It's very simple, and you engage yogic breathing through your breathing in through your nose, out through your mouth, and that's the yoga part, the yogic breathing. And basically it's just fake laughing. Your body can't tell the difference between real and fake laughter.
And it's absolutely free to us. We can fake laugh anytime we want, just like this. Oh, I hope you enjoyed that laughter, everybody. Have a lovely day. See you soon. Bye.
I love you, Thamesmead.
Hello, my name is Jerusha, and today I'm going to be singing my rendition of Lean On Me. I hope you enjoy.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
Episode. We hope you enjoyed watching that as much as we did making it. Make sure to check out all of the links below for more details on who you've been watching today, for things like the full saltfish and ackee recipe, for details on how to get involved in VE celebrations, and also contact details if you want to get in touch or send us any of your photos, ideas or videos for us to include in future episodes. So go share with your friends and family. Make sure to tag us #TEMOTV in any of your crafting, dancing or baking triumphs and disasters. You're going to have a new presenter and theme each week, so make sure to tune in next Friday.